right. Ah, that feeling. When you get up in a thermal and now you've got the whole route open to you again. Whew, it's priceless. Such a feeling of freedom. Ah, I love that. Up we go. Good morning.
So I'm here with Carlo.
And we're doing the Flybubble challenge. Look, they're already off. It's a fantastic day at Devils Dyke. We're blessed with a day of light wind, good thermals, sunshine, and lots of friendly faces out on launch.
Lots.
So the trick is to avoid the traffic. We're going to Truly over there, Devils Dyke, Ditchling, somewhere down there, and then all the way around the southern sights, try and link them all up in one flight, hike and fly, and get back to here for the pub at 7 o'clock. So let's see how we do this. I'll talk you through what I'm doing while I'm flying and while I'm on the course, and give you some ideas how to link up something like this with cross-country flying and to use the best tactics. Let's go.
Still early in the morning, so we're using the ridge to boost the thermals. The ridge line is helping the thermals trigger and run up the hill, so we're staying fairly close to the ridge line top. But as the day progresses and as things warm up, we start moving forward of the ridge, so that gives us a better opportunity to catch thermals that are going more upright and less slanted. And also the ridge stops working because the thermals are pulling off the fields in front. There's less heated air going up onto the ridge line. So you'll find if you're just soaring, it's not a good place to be. It's difficult to maintain. But if you move out, you get these wide thermals that are climbing and drawing all the warm air up in their columns. So you've got to look out for the other pilots. I'm constantly watching to see what the other pilots are doing within glide. And anybody that's climbing faster than me, I try and move over to. So I'm always getting the best climb. There you can see the cloud shadow starting. That gives you a clue of where to go next. And down track, we're gonna go along that ridge. But the trick is to not be focused on the ridge, but looking for thermal triggers. There, that big brown field is the thermal trigger that I went to, and I'm drifting back in that climb. And as I glide along, I'm noticing pilots getting very low on the ridge. So we've flown into an area that's quite tricky. And I'm being super cautious now, just trying to hold on to everything.
Really slowed down that little bowl. It's really tough to get out of. So I just had to be patient and wait. I've got something. I'm not really as high as I'd like to be. I'm not up at cloud base yet. But I'm just going to move on and hopefully find something out over the flats here. Still a way to Caburn. I need quite a bit of a climb to get over to Caburn. So hopefully I can link the cloud. Something out there. Just going to be patient. Ah, that's better.
That's really educated guesswork. and sometimes your guesses pay off and sometimes not. I'm about to go on a doomed glide here, and I go too far to the right over the shadows of the town and ultimately end up on the ground from this glide. I should have gone to the left, to that far end of the hill that was in the sun there.
Yeah, I didn't get a climb over Lewis. I was hoping to get a climb up. Clouds are still working, so that was just bad flying. I missed the climb. And the wind's very light here in Caburn. Coming in from over there, about 10 or 15 k's an hour. So it's quite a different day to when we left the dike. It's very light. Feels like it should be good thermic flying, and I don't really have any west faces here, but I'll go up Caburn and see how maybe I can sneak off the front of Caburn.
Now then, I do believe that is Robert Houston.
This is illegal. You're not allowed a thermal past me.
That's the right move. Stay up in the air. So now I've got the wind coming over the back of Caburn.
Coming from there,
the wind turbine is showing the wind coming from there. Sun's coming from that side. Let's see if I can cook something up. Oh no! There goes Houston.
Houston, we have a problem. I'm on the ground.
And yep, that's the back of Caburn. Not gonna fly very far this way.
Maybe this way. Gotta find something. Maybe in the lee, down there somewhere.
Splat! I'm on Caburn, me. Houston, there he is, he's on his way to Phil.
Should have slowed down and got another climb. I used what I could. Some days you just don't have the climbs available. I don't think I was racing, I just didn't find anything on my glide. So, quick pack, run to Phil, you can actually see the gliders on the ridge there, and get back in the air while it's still working. Catch you soon. Cool. That was a quick pack. On the legs. Let's go. Load up view ranger and check where is the nearest trail that goes up the hill. A bit further on. Looks like there's a cut through that leads up to the top. Yeah, shortcuts always cost you time. Stay on the road, Greg. Later the same day. So I'm at Firle. And clouds are nice, wind is light. But it's coming from over there, which is no good. It's not coming up on the ridge. So I'm hoping for a bit of a miracle, really. I have to wait until the wind comes onto the ridge so I can get away. Ah, if I could just get up, could carry on flying. I can see the whole, could do the whole route. High Nova, come back to New Haven. Just need to get up. See some birds. Let's go.
that feeling.
When you get up in a thermal and now you've got the whole route open to you again. Whew, it's priceless. Such a feeling of freedom. Ah, I love that. Up we go. So it looks like the sea breeze is starting to come in over there. So I might be able to drop onto the sea breeze front and ride it through. New Haven's going to be very tricky. It's in the sea air. But who knows, maybe I can soar the cliffs and get back to Brighton. The day is still on. Ah, that'll do. That's Phil down there. Next one's Bo Peep. Never up, never down, never. High and over. Like a theme in a song, clever. New Haven. Feeling high,
feeling low. This is really beautiful up here. Look at this. Feels so right, then I'm wrong. Hoping I'll be fine. But I get up, I always do. I never think, I always do. Never thought I wouldn't jump.
It's getting pretty tough now because it's into a headwind and I gotta get to New Haven. I might make it there, I don't think I'll get further, but I'll give it a try. This one's for you, Tucker. Flying to McDonald's on my paraglider. Bah! I'm getting hungry. Should we pop into the McDonald's? It's over there. Let's go grab a bite to eat.
Looking a bit lumpy down there. Can't get out the front of this field.
I'll have to go to the far end of the field and run around. I'm gonna go down there. Pop over to McDonald's, go get a bite to eat, recharge, get some power in the legs. I'm gonna try and go to the cliffs. I think maybe I'll be able to soar along the cliffs to Brighton. Check you there. I'm gonna have to move it to get back to the dike. So I've just got a message from Carlo. He's managed to complete the course, the dog. Yeah, what a master. He was flying so well. I think he was flying the Phi Maestro and he was just ahead of me. And he got a good climb at Titchling at that bowl where I got so stuck. And he's managed to link up all of the turn points, fly to New Haven and almost all the way back to the dike. So top marks to Carlo. Wow, that's another level.
So the first bit, well, we got up here and it was great. We pushed along together, didn't we? Along towards Truly Hill and had to work bits along. And then we got up quite nicely at Truly. And then we got separated because the lift was kind of quite sporadic, wasn't it? I thought I pushed off to the west a bit and just went and you came back and got up nicely, and so we scrabbled around, and then you were
playing around back here as well. Well, there was also at least three or four bird of prey. I don't know what they were, but they were flying around us at the end of Truly as well, which was lovely.
So we had loads of zigzagging, yo-yoing around here, didn't we? It was just up and down, backwards and forwards. But, and eventually kind of kicked through, and the lift then went up to about $3,000, didn't it?
Yeah.
And then we kind of formed a nice gaggle in this sort of area. You'd gone a bit further back.
Yeah.
You'd climbed off the north end of the modeler's bowl.
Yeah. Yeah, I took a line that was straight to the windmills, to Jack and Jill, just cut the line there, and you went quite far forward, but then when you came in, you were higher than me, just a bit higher,
so
that made the difference.
I decided to go off track, upwind, to get where the clouds look good, to get better climbs and just put myself in a better position. And I did that a few times and it really paid off, it worked. Sometimes you do that and you just get hammered. And you just think, oh, I've gone in the wrong direction. And I've got... But it really worked today. It was paid off. And it kept working all the way down the Ditchling Ridge, right to Lewis.
Yeah.
And in fact, even at Lewis, I went north of the hills at Lewis and purposely spent a while just drifting, because I knew I was going to have to go over the Mount Caburn sort of hills and end up in the Lee. And I didn't want to end up low in the Lee. The Caburn Hill, so I spent a while working stuff there, going backwards and forwards, and then eventually got a reasonable climb. I never got a really good climb, and of course all that patience, and as soon as I decided I'm all right now and I glided off, I went and hit a much stronger climb in the middle of the valley
and the bit from Phil to Bo Peep to Hanover.
The climbs, it was great. You'll see on my track, the thermals just kept taking me right through the cylinders, which was quite nice. But
lovely.
So it fell, just tracked out. There were clouds forming, quite nice clouds, so I followed. I deviated under them a little bit, and that kept my height. Then over fell, it didn't seem to be working around the fell takeoff, so I kind of just went past that. And then I couldn't decide quite what to do, and I again decided to go a bit more cross upwind. And so then I was risking landing, but near the A27, but I could see some clouds. And again, I got a climb, she took me over Bo Peep. And then after that, there were what looked like convergence clouds over high and over. And so I went to them and they worked really well and got up really nicely.
And then how on earth did you get New Haven?
Well, to be honest, I wasn't expecting it to work. So, well, I was out high and over, and I could, looking at the at New Haven, I could see that the clouds, cumulus clouds, were still at the coast. They weren't inland. So I was like, oh, okay, there's a bit of hope. Because normally I'd expect to get into the sea air, and it just put me down. But as I glided to New Haven, I spotted some buzzards, which got me up. So I had to work quite a bit to keep my height there. And then ironically, the bit that I thought was going to be really difficult, as I arrived at New Haven and glided in, there was like a convergence. So I just almost straight lined the, got a really good lift.
He's making me want to cry.
And then from New Haven, there were a couple of sailplanes buzzing up and down. It was just wonderful, to be honest. It was just...
Oh, just stop it. He just flew straight and he just went up.
Well, the sailplanes were flatting up and down, so they were marking the lift. And, you know, sailplanes generally don't bother with the lift unless it's really good. They tend to just, because of your performance. So they were marking the really good lift. And then from there, you know where Kingston Ridge, or Kingston and the ridge behind? So there was a cloud over Loose Bottom. And again, I was just pushing forwards, getting bits, pushing forwards. So I had, to be honest, a fairly easy time. And then at the end, I probably should have gone right over Brighton where the convergence clouds were, but I decided to just be more cautious and I kept on the edge of the town. I pushed north and it was still working, but not quite as well. Yeah, then I just kept pushing forward and got glided, just landed just behind the dike.
Woohoo! Brilliant. And there's the dike. Good work.
Don't know if you guys can see, but it's very side on. The seagulls are just managing to soar. Wind is really... Okay, so I'm going to walk to that point where the wind is angled much better on the ridge. Maybe if I was a seagull, I would do this, but I don't like the direction. It's pretty straight into wind along this cliff line. It's high tide. I don't need to do this. So I think this is where my foot and fly ends. I walk along the coast, get a bus back to the dike. If it had been a little bit around from the south, I could have sawed this piece. But I'm not going to take the risk here. So, I hope you enjoyed that. I certainly did. That was a lot of fun. Gave it my all. Didn't quite make it. But it's been a cracking day out. Really good to challenge myself. And such a beautiful part of the world to fly. So, onwards down the coast. Head west, they say. Check out this house. Awesome, eh? And that one's pretty cool too. Really pretty coastal walk. Runs all the way to Brighton. So you've probably heard of the Greenwich Meridian. There it is. So we go east, west, east, west, east, west. Go west, they say. So I've just got a ride from Nancy.
Hello.
How organized is that? On the train, on the bus, and I happened to get onto the 27, which went all the way up to the top of this road. Hopped off the bus and got a ride with Nancy. Yay!
Go and celebrate the pub.
Yay! So now we dig the last little bit to the dike.
Sunset.
Sunsets over the South Downs. It's just gorgeous. What a day. Who the man? To run the last bit because this is the Devil's Dyke. Oh wow, so that's the end of the day. There's the Truly Run. Beautiful sunset. Woo-hoo. People enjoying picnics. And our winner, Carlo Borsattino, who just appeared out of his office, picked up a glider, and ripped around the course. So, I can only say, maestro. So firstly, what were you flying, Carlo?
The maestro?
Maestro.
Maestro.
Yeah. That was purely a marketing exercise. I mean, it was just to show the glider off and had nothing to do with it.
It was work. I had to work.
Yeah.
Now, what a lovely day, eh? Wonderful, bloody amazing day.
We all did the Truly Run together. That was
really nice.
So that was lovely.
It was a bit bouncy, like sporty this morning, I find. It was it's a surprisingly rough.
Yeah, it was when it was still mixing and the thermals hadn't broken through. So it was all... Yeah, I found that as well.
Yeah.
Sporty stuff.
What was your strategy? Your winning strategy?
My strategy was, because there was a fair bit of northerly wind, wasn't there? So I kept trying to work myself into a good position with the wind, trying to push upwind a bit, following the clouds. And just got very lucky with lovely gaggles of birds. There were some really massive gaggles of seagulls. I had a couple of gaggles with 100 seagulls in them. I was looking around for birds. Is there, are there any birds? I'm trying to spot any. There's 100 seagulls climbing out. Yeah, so that was good. And then there were quite a few sailplanes today, loads of them.
Mm.
So I ended up, yeah, just following the clouds and sailplanes, really.
So that wraps up the Flybubble challenge. Had a fantastic day. Everybody's had some flying. Everybody's had different stories. Mm. We've all done different things, and I think we've used the day. The most that could have been done on the day, I think. It was a really, really good challenge. And we'll see you again when we have it again. That was very impromptu. We'll just decide when the forecast looks good to do another one. Mm-hmm. If you're in the area, come and join us. It's very casual. You're most welcome. It's a nice way to see the sights and to find out about flying in the southern area. And just to push your XC and route finding a little bit. So thanks for watching. We'll catch you next time.
Bye.
Cheers.
If you're able to contribute in any way, we'd appreciate it. It's what makes this kind of production possible.